The past 24 hours have been some of the craziest, most volatile times that we have seen in a very long time. Bitcoin dropped to a low of $29,800, which made the pullback, the correction from its previous all-time high, about 54%. It has since bounced back up about 33%, as you guys can see here, where it's currently sitting around $39,755. Today, it's gone up as high as about $42,000. Now, the question that everyone is asking, why, right? Why did it drop so fast and so low to levels that we haven't seen in months? Why has it now bounced so hard? Is the bull run over? Is this the beginning of the bear cycle? Well, you know that we are always hard at work trying to find the answers to bring to you guys. And today is no different. Today we are bringing you a story of an anonymous user who posted on the 4chan message boards that this was going to happen before it happened. He called the bottom, which was they were going to push the prices down to $30,000. And he called a top for the bull cycle, where he said that after the bottom, that the prices would go right back up very quickly. And that by the end of this bull cycle, Bitcoin will be over $100,000. You guys don't want to miss this one. Stay tuned. Hey, what's up? Jay here, and welcome to Bitcoin Daily, bringing you guys the best tips, tutorials, and ideas to help you guys become profitable and successful investors. The goal of this channel is to empower you guys with the knowledge and resources to take you up to that next level. So make sure you guys smash the like button on this video to help us with, of course, the YouTube algorithm. And if you guys are new here, if this is your first rodeo on this channel, make sure to subscribe, make sure to turn on those notification bells as well. All right, guys, so first of all, let's go ahead and take a look at this crazy, crazy chart, guys. If you guys watched Monday's video, we spoke about the head and shoulders pattern. If you guys watched Friday's video, we spoke about the head and shoulders pattern. We spoke about this exact scenario, right? Now, we didn't predict this scenario, right? We just spoke about it. Remember, we gave you guys a bullish scenario and a bearish scenario on Friday. Then on Monday, I told you guys that because of all the Elon Musk tweets, it put more pressure on the selling, and we broke the neckline here for the head and shoulders. So that had told us that the bearish scenario was now in play. And what happened, I told you guys that my price target in this bearish scenario was going to be $30,000 from this break, right? And where did we hit, guys? We hit the exact price target. Now, I'm not happy or proud to have, you know, gave this scenario, but I did give you guys this information, all right? And, you know, we got this information just by reading the charts, looking at the charts, looking at the pattern, taking in market sentiment and what was going on. And we were able to give you basically this scenario and what could happen and how low it could go, etc., etc. So I hope you guys watched that video and watched those videos and, you know, acted on it. I didn't do anything. I didn't sell anything, but I also didn't take any new short-term trades or anything like that while this started happening. Once I saw this pattern in play, I stopped even in the VIP group. I stopped giving trades out because we weren't taking any trades at the time. So you guys can see that we went as low as $29,800, and now we've gone up. We've bounced up as high as around $42,444. So today it is a green day. You can see here the pattern that's still in play though, right? You see that we still have this falling wedge, guys. What is a falling wedge? A falling wedge is a bullish reversal signal. So we still are in this falling wedge pattern. You can see it very clearly here on the daily chart. you can see on the 4-hour chart as well. You could also see that we are exhausted here. This is another bullish signal. We are exhausted and we were in oversold territory. And now you can see that the RSI is pointing back to the upside. That is another bullish signal. Lastly, you can see this huge wick to the downside and you know, it closed back within. Not only did it close within this falling wedge here, but it closed above, let me see, did it close above 30? So it didn't actually close above 38,000. So it closed around 36,000 last night, almost 37, and now currently we're around that 39,000. So these are all bullish things. When there's a long wick like this, that means that that the price is exhausted from going in the, down in this direction. So when you put all these things together, it gives you some reversal signals. We're starting to see the reversal signals here. So for me, I need to see a break above 42,000 because 42,000, remember, has been that very strong level. It was a previous all-time high. We've bounced off of it before. We've been rejected by it before. And it's also a Fibonacci level. So 42,000 for me has a lot of power there. I want to see a bounce above that before I start hopping into some trades here. Possible trades are also around that 38K range. But a bounce above 42 would signal a bounce above a very big level as well as a bounce out of this falling wedge. So breaking above 42K could potentially mean a breakout out of the falling wedge. So that's currently what we're watching for the next few days, and we'll dive more into this analysis in tomorrow's video. But today we want to talk about this anonymous user who posted before it even happened. He posted about this drop down to 30K as a form of manipulation by the elites, and he said that it would bounce back up very rapidly and that by the end of this bull market we would hit above $100,000 for Bitcoin. So let's jump right into that. So guys, before we continue, make sure that you smash that like button, guys, and subscribe to the channel. Make sure to turn on the notification bells as well. Let's smash the like button together. Are you guys ready? Let's do it on 3, 1, 2, 3, boom, like button smashed. So here is the news, guys. A 4chan insider predicted yesterday's Bitcoin dump. FUD says it was China-led shakeout. So this anonymous user who predicted the latest crypto bloodbath says that it was just a competition between some shady elites. So this user predicted this about 12 hours before it happened. He said that it was an organized China-related campaign aimed at a single shareholder. He went on to say that he can't tell you guys what firm I work for, but it's massive and it's working with the PRC. PRC means the People's Republic of China. He went on to say that the low all depended on how many other firms were liquidated in the process. This is going to be big and fast, he said. 35K limit order if you want to be safe, but you can probably go as low as 31.25K. So he went on to say that this was a coordinated sell-off to drop the prices below a certain threshold and liquidate one certain stakeholder. He said he can't outright say who he is, but he bought a lot at the dip that he was partly responsible for. The user claimed, adding, once liquidated, the plan is then to buy up all the reserves and essentially leave him bankrupt. He also suggested that the sell-off will drastically slow down at around 1 p.m. GMT on May 19th. Which was also on point. After that, prices would move back into the green zone, and they did, as he promised. So this is where things get a little crazy. So he basically hit on all of those. He called the drop, right? He called the price where the drop was going to go to, and he called the bounce on it, and he said it was gonna bounce very, very fast back into the green. Then he went on to predict where the all-time highs for Bitcoin was going to be by the end of this cycle. He went on to say that this bull run's all-time highs tops out well above $100,000. Do not trust the FUD. This movement is just a silly game that the elites are playing. The insider claimed, concluding that after the dip, things are going to get green really fast. We project 70K. So that all sounds pretty bizarre, right? But here's the actual message boards, guys, that you can see where he posted. Here you can see at what time he posted. And you can see here that this was on the 18th. He called the announcement from China. As you guys know, that China's central bank released a document that called for a ban on financial institutions and payment providers dealing in crypto. The reports were later proved to be somewhat misleading. Remember that this is kind of what led down to that, where basically we dropped down to 42-40K range, right? Then he wrote, the purpose of today's press release alongside all the FUD posting is to get BTC as low as it can get before 7 a.m. UCT. And he ends the post with, if you guys want to get rich, grab some coffee and watch for the big dip. Once it happens, things are going to get green really fast. So you guys can check this out for yourself. He went on to speak about a few other things. He replied to some of the people that were typing here that were asking questions about this. And then, like we showed you earlier, he said that he believes that this bull cycle will top off well above 100K. Now, of course, this all needs to be taken with a grain of salt. There's not really much proof, and there probably will never be proof. But he did call it before it all happened. So was this actually planned by China? Is this actually a game being played by the elites with billions and billions of dollars that they have the power to move the market in such a way? I mean, if it's true, then it's definitely concerning for Bitcoin overall and the whole crypto market, because you're basically saying that the elites will always have control of crypto. So if they have control, if they have power, then that kind of puts us right back to where we are currently with centralized banks and centralized governments. If the top elites alone, which is the 0.01%, can control the prices, then they're controlling and centralizing the crypto market as well. So of course, all of this is kind of getting into that rabbit hole of conspiracy theory, but just something that I wanted to show you guys and put out there for you guys. Another idea it's always good to be open to all the different ideas and to try to get a better understanding on how markets work and the possibilities that are out there in the markets, right? So does China really have that much power over Bitcoin in the grand scheme of things? I don't know. You guys tell me. Let me know in the comments below what you think about this whole thing. Do you think this thing is real, or do you think this is more conspiracy theory? Let me know below what you guys think. If you guys have any questions as well, let me know in the comments. Thank you guys so much for tuning into this video. Make sure to smash that like button so that we can continue to pump this price back up to $100,000, guys. If you're new, make sure to subscribe and turn on the notification bell. I will be with you guys tomorrow for the next video. As always, peace and love.